video, I'm going to show you how to implement matlab or VHDL in image processing applications with the help of matlab and system generator. So in the last video, we will see how to implement our own modules, own matlab or VHDL files in matlab environment through Xilinx. So here I'm going to use the same adder to add two images and we will get the output in FPGA board. For that I am using system generator environment to implement the final matlab or VHDL file to the FPGA kit. So for that, first of all, take the Xilinx library browser, then similar to the previous video, we have to create a new and title file, then save that file in the corresponding folder with the name Co-Simulation Put, save it, then open Xilinx library browser, take Xilinx block set, then choose basic elements, in that choose system generator, then choose your gateway in, then choose your gateway out, then gateway in, gateway out, then the black box. So we have to use the same adder that we have already been created in the previous video. So it shows the configure file which is already created. So just the same configuration has been used, so the warning is coming. Then after this, you know, because this is a normal adder, normal 8-bit adder, it will add 2 elements and we will get a 9-bit result including the carry input. So here, what is the problem means, for adding only 2 individual elements, not a problem, but in terms of applying the image, we are having a image in terms of matrices. That means you know, image will be a person of 2x2, sorry, number of rows into columns. So in the matrix, in the matlab, the image will be a person of as like a matrix format. So we have to convert that images that has been transmitted one by one, that is pixel by pixel. So for that we need additional elements to give inside the processing element. So for that, what we have to do means within additional block sets that has been taken from DSP blocks, and we need to get the input image and we need to show the output. So for that, go to computation system tools or and in that you are having sources and choose image for file and add to cofim to it, and again choose the Xilinx library browser, in that we are having syncs, so to display the corresponding output, so that we have to choose the video viewer and choose here. So actually if I directly instantiate this two files with the gateway in, and if I see the output, definitely it will give the error because we are having an images in two format, but here the gateway in port which will actually get the inputs as sequential order, so only it will process only one element at a time. So if I choose a run command, it shows the error since it is having 3x3 dimension. That means RGB element, that means the color image, and it is having rows of 386 and the column size of 512. So if I directly feed this input to the gateway in, definitely it shows the error. So we have to convert these elements into individual pixels. So for that we need additional blocks that has been taken from the DSP system toolbox I already said. So in that what are the blocks we needed means, so in the signal management buffers the quotient, then unbuffer, sorry, then in the indexing and the signal attributes, we need to convert 1D to 2D, and convert 2D to 1D, then now we are converting the image into 2D to 1D. Then we need a signal attributes in a frame conversion block. Frame conversion block. So what we need is actually we are using that frame conversion. Before that we need to convert the two dimensional image into one dimensional image. So next we have to convert that one dimensional data into frame conversion. So it is transfer that data as a frame by frame. Then we will be using that unbuffer. Then it will again given to the input. Given to the input of gateway in, then similarly at the output side we will use the buffer, then our one dimensional image into two dimensional data, then we need to connect that one dimensional 1D to 2D box into the video viewer block. Now similarly for one input I am choosing one image, and here what I am choosing means I am using some constant block. So constant we know from the common use blocks, in that the sources we are having constant block, so you just add that constant block to the gateway in. Now I am choosing some final some value 1. So in that I am having a three dimension, so it's a three dimensional image, that means it is having a both R, G, B, three components. So one thing what I have to do means I have to process the individual element as an separate R, G and B components, or if I have to feed that image as a grayscale image. So simply I am choosing the separate color signal, so it will create a three components of it will create a file, create an image with the three components R, N, G and B. Now what I am choosing means I am simply adding one value to the image. Now I have to do some changes in the blocks. anyway, we don't want to change the CO to D2 and then frame commission and buffer and buffer. So just keep that values as a default. So we don't want to change any parameters on that input side. And here what you have to do means already you know this 8-bit adder. So 8-bit adder means you are having you have to choose the input as a fixed point and the arithmetic type was unsigned and choose that number of bits as 8 bits. And we are not using a fixed point notation, that means we are not having any floating point, so we have to use that binary point as 0. Then okay, so similarly do the similarly do the next get in. Then choose that value. So here the output buffer size will be 64. So we know the actual size 384 into 512. So for increase of speed, actually the size is small means it will take less time to process. So what I have to do means I am resizing the corresponding image. So in that geometric transformation from the computation system toolbox, I am choosing the resize block. And here I am choosing number of output rows and columns, and in that I am choosing as 128 space 128. The size of the image will be 128 plus 128. So I am using that 128 space 128 and choose OK. Then I am just interconnecting these two blocks. So here we know the size of the image is 128 into 128. So choose a size as like a image size. So that's 128 plus 128. And the number of output rows will be 128. Similarly, the number of output columns will be also 128. Now I save the model. And here, what is the size of image that we have to choose as in simulation time? So here 128 into 128 is our simulation time. Now choose it. Now save it. Now run the simulation. So after the process, actually we did all the things in the correct order. So what I have to do means I am change here as an interim thing. Here unsigned integer 8-bit, and here I am using one more step. I am choosing that output buffer. Okay, then reshape, that's also no problem. Here I'm converting the data type, because we know that this block will give you a 9-bit result, and here you are having a 8-bit and here also 8-bit data. But here the sum block which will process 8-bit element, and it will give us an output as a 9-bit image. So we don't know, most probably if the result more than 8-bit means definitely that value will be truncated. So we have to use that data type conversion block. So for that, transform text and graphics morphological geometric conversion. in the data type conversion, or else use that normal data type conversion from signal attributes, and in the choose unsigned integer 8 bit. Now across gateway out and buffer, you will get a output like that. So first of all, can I check whether I get a correct output? Here we are getting the exact output, but only here you will get a wrong output. Found 128 and here some 128 bit 0.0, and here round. So it shows output 2 of 3 is not connected, output 3 of from 5 is not connected, so we left unopen. That's why the output won't show correctly. Integer 8 bit, sending is 16 bit. Here want this problem, signal attributes, integer 8 bit name, and it's 0. No, definitely we get a correct output. So for that, so here we have to check whether we are getting the correct output across gateway out. So choose the syncs block and choose the display and add to the core simulation file. Then now check it. So here what we have done what we did wrong means actually we didn't choose the simulation mode. So if it is an inactive, means definitely the inputs that are not feeding into the black box. So what we have to do means choose the ISC simulator, then play and OK. Now if you are using that and convert the logs, that's it. So we get a output. Now if I am varying this input as a 25, and so this is a saturated region. So we already know actually for this is a image scaling, so for a particular value, after some certain values, it will enhance the image. So after that particular value, what it will do means actually it will saturate it, and the value all around this region will be black or white. So this is the actual application. So if I'm using 3 dimensions, here you have to process individually all the elements, either at G or B. So based on the requirement, you have to choose whether it's a color image or a grayscale image. So for a study purpose, I'm just realizing it's that color image I'm just individually choose that R component, the processing the particular component and visualizing the corresponding portion. So I hope you all understood the application of image processing. That means the image processing application that has been used inside MATLAB and FPGA. Thank you.